In today's video, we'll explore the process of creating a modular character from the perspective of 3D artist. This video is all about giving you insights into what I do and why it matters. It won't cover the sculpting or texturing process. Instead, I want to draw your attention to the various stages of work and explain the nuances involved. Welcome to the very first video in the character art category. I hope you've already watched the project overview video to get a sense of what we're embarking on. If you haven't, you can find the link in the description below. Hey, I'm Yolo! Basic character mesh. Sculpt, retopology, naming, UV. First things first, we need to sculpt the detailed Highpoly model of our character's bare body. Remember, our character should also be bald. Next, we'll work on retopology, creating a clean and optimized base mesh. This base mesh will become our best friend throughout the project. It allows us to quickly create different clothing pieces by simply cutting and modifying parts. Plus, it'll make the skinning process a breeze. Now, let's not forget the importance of UV unwrapping our low poly model. At this stage, we encounter the need to cut the model for the first time. In my case, I plan to have different facial variations, so I detach the head and create a separate UV map for it. And of course, we'll make sure the body has its own UV unwrap too. Keep in mind that even though our model may be symmetrical, it's best to unwrap the entire model, as we may want to add asymmetrical elements to the texture in the future, like tattoos for example. Remember, it's good practice to align the UV islands either horizontally or vertically, ensuring that the textured patterns look perfect and seamless. Last but not least, we need to come up with fun and easy to understand names for our low poly and high poly models. Since we'll be using Substance Painter for texturing, it's helpful to add low and high at the end of respective model names to differentiate between them. By following these steps, we'll have a solid foundation to build upon as we continue creating our modular characters. Transforming a basic character mesh into a modular. Now that we have our high poly and low poly models ready, it's time for the most exciting part. Deciding where our modular parts will attach and how many of them we will have. So here's what I have chosen for myself. My character will have 5 cuts. Sweater, trousers, boots, gloves and head. Let me clarify something important. Although the character has 5 cuts, I've decided to create 10 modular parts. Face, hair, cap, sweater, trousers, gloves, socks, boots, backpack, belt. Now that we've figured out how many cuts we'll have, let's choose the perfect loops for them. We'll look for loops that sit right at the junction of 2 parts and mark them. It's super important to remember which loops we've selected because we'll need to align new clothing parts with them perfectly, vertex to vertex. That way we can avoid any gaps or clipping issues. The magic happens when every piece of clothing perfectly matches those chosen loops. It creates the illusion of seamlessly changing outfits, where players won't even notice that we've swapped out the entire body part. So let's make sure our character's new wardrobe fits flawlessly. Mesh normals. An important tip to keep in mind. Whenever I work on new models, I make sure to transfer the normals from the intact base model to the cut parts of the character. This little trick helps us to avoid any strange shadows or visual issues that can happen if the normals are not perfectly matching in Unreal Engine. Save your base model backup! And hey, remember to save all your hard work as a backup in a separate file. Trust me, you wouldn't want to discover in the middle of creating a new set of clothes that you accidentally used the original low poly body. And now it's gone! Having a backup copy stored somewhere safe is a lifesaver. It's been a pleasure sharing this with you. Next time we'll dive into sculpting. Stay awesome!